came back. I really need to figure out how to do the intermission thing, because I don't really need to be split up into another video. But never mind, it happens. Right, so we're trying to get into this place. So I figure if I go up this staircase... And I've not got my headphones back in. So I've got to be... It's got to be there, isn't it? Does that make sense? Probably doesn't matter, does it? So if I... Oh, there we go, down here. Ah, it was nearly the end of the chapter. This with leaf suits may venture near during increased production. Finds a way. Well, this stream is doing wonders for my trophy collection. How many acorns?
Virginia King, May 19th, 1943. The Sisurians, much like other indigenous peoples, seem to hold strong cultural values of legendary creatures. The most notable one being the creature depicted on all these doorways. It resembles the mythological Wendigo, a fierce creature with an insatiable desire to consume flesh. The creature is most often linked with both greed and famine, acting as a balance of nature. Why would this creature hold such a strong cultural significance?
This is really cool. Back when I was in the, last week when I was in the facility place, I was kind of worried that they were going to end the game in that kind of area. So I'm glad that there's a whole other portion that's a bit more, that's more of the nature stuff going on. Also more of this stuff. I've got to do the trees, so I'm looking for another tree somewhere. Oh, maybe I opened this. Yes, I did. Cool. Well, Wait, so if those guys... So the story behind those guys last time was that the things that are flying at you are actually one of the swarm, one of the bee things, sort of doing a suicide throw and, like, dive at you. So what do the Wendigos do then? What are they throwing at you? Is it just energy bombs, or are they surrounded by more bees? Yet more bees! Later, that very same bee... That should have been a runner. But it didn't seem to want me to speed up. Yeah, I know. I'm gonna have to go right all the way from here. Goodbye. What do you reckon? That seems like enough of a runner. Come along right when it's doing this soothing nature music. Ooh, don't worry about that. I'm just gonna do the cool music. So I do get a second line on my energy thing. So I wasn't at the end. I hadn't even noticed when I got that.
The pyramid built by the Saurians served as a ceremonial structure exalting the Colossi. Along with the Titan Tree and Daemon, they intertwine and form a mythology. From what I gathered, the Colossi were once humans who feasted upon the forbidden fruit, corrupting them into giant monstrosities, cannibalizing their fellow man and devouring all life within the valley. A tale of caution? Are the Saurians warning us against abusing the power of the life seed?
Sheer amount of effort the Saurians went to constructing these architectural marvels is astonishing. It's a bit hard to understand sometimes. They've clearly grasped forms of advanced mathematics to able to construct such structures. How long did it take them? How large of a population has sustained it? Would have been thousands. Wendigo mythology is utterly fascinating. Not only do they reflect famine and harsh winters, but also greed and gluttony. Sometimes even humans overcome with greed could turn into a Wendigo, doomed to feast upon the flesh of man for the rest of their lives, never feeling satiated. Sometimes they are depicted as ever-growing as they can consume more and more flesh. Will I sleep tonight? Just a myth, Virginia. Just a myth. I'm not sure you'd bother to write that down, but fine. Cool. Christ, 30 medallions. I'm in 33. Cool. Just enough, really. And And this is when I find out that there's more doors to require more medallions within the thing. And I'm gonna have to go back to all the other levels and find some more. Oh look, there is another door. Can't believe we're the first squad to collect enough medallion skins like this place. The land sharks can eat it. To be fair, we owe a lot of it to these weird prototype upgrades we were ordered to test out. We should make this pyramid our new base camp. This magical fire fires in here spooked me a little. Don't worry about it. What do you think it is? Viper coil nullifies its energy cost. Ah, okay. Like, that wasn't a huge issue, but fine. Well, does that mean I'm just going to be doing loads of swinging in the next section? Requires 40 medallions! Okay, this might be an extra area, and I actually need to just go over the pyramid. So, because it says get to the Astro facility, it doesn't say get to the pyramid. Because from, yeah, here we go. So, because from past experience, I thought I needed acorns to get to the next point, I didn't. So yeah, there's no way the game was going to force me to go back and find that 40 medallions. That's a lot! So I've... Yeah, there's quite a bit that I've not done yet then. Or extra stuff that I haven't done. So that means I could do the next bit without that upgrade, the coil upgrade. Acorns aren't falling anymore, they're just appearing kind of near the tree. Okay, I don't need to do that anymore, the valley is healthy enough. Smoke Lake. Ah look, there's another one of these things. Whoa. So this is the Astro. Okay, like everything is dead. Except for that tree. And that tree. And the grass. But lots of things are dead. Yes. I am the life giver! Love me! Oh. Oh. Boom! You're alive again. I help the deer! You should like me! Why did I just miss every single shot? Right, where are you? Whoa, you just came out of nowhere. That's not fair. Hmm. that, but the Wendigos are leaving acorns behind. Probably didn't need to aim for that platform, but just being safe. This is a pretty cool location. I quite like this. Oh my god! They cling together, so you don't realize there's two. Oh my god! Where are you all coming from? Weird when Deagle guard dogs. Might be the first time I've been able to use all of the batteries that I found in the crate. Just steal that. Yeah, there we go. I do like that I can turn the little vines green. I'd not really thought about it. Because near the start it says, oh, you can't do it to grass because there's not enough in grass. Bullshit. Sounds like, yeah, okay, they just want you to do it to trees, but the fact that you can do it to those little vines as well is quite cool. Hi, birdies. Oh, look at your weird faces. I really did miss something. So what's this one? Oh, it's just gonna let me run water. Yes! Lake Skipper. That's one I wasn't expecting. Considering they build this whole thing up of...
I have tasked the Valkyrie path
like, don't go near the water.
The Lake Skipper upgrade for the leaf suit. The lake near the Astra facility should prove ideal for the assessment. I expect a full report on my desk as soon as testing is complete.
That's cool.
Oh,
things, like visual counter for how long I can do it for, but there's like a little beep going off. So I assume that's the only kind of warning I get for to stop it. So this game really does know how to give you something fun to do, and then is determined to give you equally fun music to go along with it. Wait, is this using my energy? No? Oh, it's not using anything. It's interesting. I love how far you go once you get that speed up. It's so much fun. So many other games need this exoskeleton thing. It's just so good. I mean, imagine playing like The Witcher or Dragon Age. That's in all of the open world stuff, you just get to do this. Whoa! Holy shit, I'm going so fast! Grateful for the thumbsticks in the PS4 that have that kind of ridge on them. Because when you're just holding forward in a direction on the old PS3, you'd just be like, your thumb would be slipping. And I'd have to do this thing where I'd then put my thumb on top and then change my position. Really good. So I've said it before, the running, jumping, all the fun stuff with the exoskeleton, definitely worth the price of the mission. Like, I think it's still in the January sales, if that's still going on PS4. It's like £6 something. Get it. Just do it. Well, there's some water for me to see on. So let's get a bottle up. Place contain any core metals within the Astro facility. Pumping stations will continuously divert water from the lake into Astro. I'm gonna have salivation. Because it's midway through January, so of course we still have some left from Christmas. galaxy. Kurt Bobo. I'm glad it didn't take me dying to figure that out or to come across it. Controller is going fucking mental. Am I supposed to be coming down here? I hope so. Seems like I am. Some sprites here. What are these guys doing down here? But they've sort of been everywhere. Is it really that big of a question? Some land in the middle of that. Yes and no! So I'm just gonna ignore that. Okay, this is actually getting quite tough. So I actually got one. Is that the other one? I wonder if I should actually ignore a rope swing and just run across the water, because I'm getting the feeling that if I swing and just land in it, then that's not skipping on it. But would, is the fall from this going to be as much? This is the first time I've actually worried about dying, because I've used up like two sections of my leaf things in the end. So yeah, those vines could help me get back up, the valley energy back up. Because remember, that is essentially my life, or how many lives I get. Nice, war siren. That's exactly what we want. Fallout siren, whatever you want to call it. Okay, I've got a leaf back. So yeah, they're gonna... These vines are definitely gonna help me. Anything else in here? So I'm not looking too bad. Wow, there's stuff everywhere. Oh, am I supposed to do this? Yes, I am. I love that this game just encourages you to just like fucking fall everywhere. Go for it. Human bones? What? Oh. Whoa. I would not have noticed that. Okay, I might. Oh shit, feeding ground. Okay, I run out of energy and I die. Holy crap, but it just put you right in the middle of it. Oh my god. Is that it? Whoa. Okay, let's try and knock it back. Holy shit. Ah! bad. Well, now I know what happens when you run out of energy. The Brahmastra will be the greatest warlords ever seen. I should be able to gather enough Amrita energy to produce 100 megaton bomb. Can you imagine? Every nation on Earth will tremble before this unprecedented. I was hoping that was going to be instructions to turn it off. I'm clearly missing one of those light switch thingies. Siren is so stressful. The stars have brought Amrita energy for 54 days before eventually dying. Aww. So that's the deal. All the stuff that I've been collecting, taking it, is free energy, is these little guys as eggs. So kind of like props. I don't feel that terrible about it, but yeah, that's quite a nice twist. So I thought the game was going to make me make some horrible decisions, but turns out I was doing that without even realizing. Deep, man. Deep.
Since we had to catch the saboteurs in the act, we allowed them access into the Astra facility during their night of attack. Admittedly, their plan was rather genius. Since Astra and Soma are linked, they intended to fire the Thanatos cannon connected to Astra's thermal storage at the Soma facility's energy reservoir to create a feedback loop of amplifying intensity until the system blows out, not unlike a microphone to a speaker.
Finish what she started.
Necessary for the amplification, thus creating a harmless feedback loop when they attempted to fire Thanatos. Without the life seed, their plan was doomed to fail from the beginning. I will not tolerate any more disruptions. We have lost too much ground to Manhattan. Operations will resume exponentially. If the orbs will not suffice, then we'll use the damn valley itself.
See, goes in there. So I assume my characters had a change of heart, because when I took the life seed out, I still thought that was to do with the character just wanted to do something cool instead of having a normal gap year like everyone else. Whoa. But now they've given up the license. So, yeah, maybe they've had a change of heart? Maybe it's what they wanted the whole time. Why is that? This isn't where it puts in the game to go. But how am I gonna go back for some like extra medallions to get? Break everything.
Danger. Thermal core meltdown detected. Cooling protocol initiated. All personnel must vacate the premise immediately through emergency corridors.
Escape.
I
should be happy, I'm doing this for you. As soon as water comes on. Is that the idea? That might be the idea. Let me fix it.
of Astra 4. The power to control the world will lie within the hands of a small few. Every nation on Earth will tremble.
Ah, rubbish. So I've ditched the suit. Why would her I go have a look around again and see if she can find any more suits? I wouldn't give it up. Valley. So I tweeted last week that I was enjoying this, and Blue Isle Studios liked my tweet, so shout out to them for liking this stuff. So that was good fun! I enjoyed that. Really good length of game as well. That was probably 4 or 5 hours total, something like that. Yeah, so I like games this late. It's one of the reasons I've kind of got into indie games a lot more in the last couple of years. Because the older you get, the less patience you have for like the 40, 50, 60 hour games or more. Less interested in doing the tiny side missions all the time. I mean, even the difference between playing when Watch Dogs 1 came out and Watch Dogs 2. Watch Dogs 1, I was doing all the side missions, doing all sorts of little things here and there. But Watch Dogs 2, I just got to a point where I just wanted to get to the end. So give me something that is manageable that I can get to the end of and tell the story. I suppose it did have a story, but a lot of it was in the past. Flashbacks and notes and things. Yeah, so that was good. I like that. Like I said before, just the running and jumping in the leaf suit, worth the price. Definitely. A lot of fun. I'm very glad that the second facility was overgrown and had more of an end. It was actually more of a something built out of the rock. Because I was really worried the game was just going to end in this place without plant life or anything. Which just seems silly when it's built up this whole myth of giving and taking life from nature. Yeah, I like that. Apparently this guy's name is Slender the Arrival, one of the Slenderman games. That. I need to kind of be a little bit horror-ish with the blood on the ground and the monsters here. But I'm interested to see what they do next. And what I am going to do next, I'm not sure. I just noticed how dark I am. Sorry guys, I've sort of been sat here in the dark. I would really like to play the next Digimon game when that comes out. I think it comes out in a couple of weeks. I basically just really wanted to play an RPG stylish game. Been debating getting Stardew Valley, but I might hold off on that for a bit. could start. Did you want Cyber Sleuth? But I would probably not sit and stream the whole thing. It would just be a taster. So no, I think I'll wait for the next Digimon game and stream that. Possibilities for other games. Always going to go back to Overwatch every now and again. We really want to play the Attack on Titan game. Don't know if that's going to be a let's play or we're going to stream it, but I really want Jack to play that one. I seem to get the controller a lot on these games, so I'm going to give Jack a go. I've also got another idea for a one-off let's play, but that's going to involve stealing Rachel for a day. Other than that, I'm not sure. So if there's anything you'd like to see me play, please let me know. I'm just gonna sit through the credits because I kind of breathe. And I changed some settings earlier, so I don't know whether I'm actually now streaming Valley rather than Overwatch. Let's have a look. No, I'm streaming Overwatch. I know that's just something I'm gonna have to live with. And I know that for a fact that next time I play Overwatch, it will probably finally say I'm playing Valley. But never mind. If you've only just appeared and you're looking at these credits wondering what the hell's going on, please head to YouTube. And so this is going on the on here on MZ's in 3D, but all of our joint videos and things are gonna go on the T Fancier channel. So that's T is in the drink, and then Fancy is F-A-N-C-I-E-R-S. I should probably do a link at the bottom, actually. And if you follow me on Twitter, my name's right there, then you'll find links and whatnot. So they're all going to go in here, so if you've just joined me for the credits, you can start the beginning. Part 1 is on YouTube. As are parts 2 and 3. Today has been split up into 3 videos, so that's gonna be 6 parts altogether. I'm sorry if there's a lot of sections where I didn't talk very much. I was a bit quiet, but the idea of these streams, the Sunday streaming. Oh, you can continue your journey by seeking out all the secrets hidden throughout the valley. Thank you for playing. So the idea of these Sunday streams was that they were supposed to be laid back. I mean, I always saw streams as more laid back than to let's plays anyway. But I always wanted it to be laid back and calm. I am in my late 20s now, and I am not a fan of screaming YouTubers. I like things to be cool and quiet and calm. So I'm gonna try and tread the line between calm and fun. I could be myself, guys. So yeah, so the idea was it was supposed to be a relaxed, informal thing. If you feel like it's too quiet, let me know, and then I will put more effort into inviting people to come along, and then maybe there'll be other people than me to chat to you. If you've liked this, please let me know. I might leave this all set up and possibly stream Jack when he comes home. maybe some Overwatch. I don't know. Anyway, I hope you have fun on this. I really liked this game a lot. And it's always nice to just sort of like tick off a game and put that in the dump pile. So, on to the next thing. So thanks for joining me. See you soon.